Okay, for next year's garden now, seeing what this looks like, I'm gonna have this a little bit better set up. The beans that are here in the front, we got the purple hull peas, and those beans right there, and purple hull peas. Then I have two purple hull peas back there. One, two, three, four, five. See, that's how I'll do it. I'll take these beans right here, this purple hull pea, that bean, that purple hull pea, and I'm gonna move them to the back here. Okra. That'll probably be the next things. That the okra will come up front here. Actually, this is considered the back of the garden. I'll put like right here, I've got seven of the red okra and I've got six of the green okra. I'll put those back here. The tomatoes will be spread out more from where they are at the beginning over there to to about where the second green okra and this first red burgundy okra is at. That'll be spread out more that way. So that'll take care of the first two rows. It'll be beans and okra in the first row and the tomato plants on the second row. Actually, let's see here. One, two, three, four. No, this first row will be mostly beans and maybe like two, three green okra, and then the next row over will be the second row over will be more will be green okra and the tomatoes. But again, the tomatoes got to be spread out more because they're just too condensed right here. When I planted them, I didn't think they would be so full. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are the real big ones. 8 tomato plants. 9 and 10, there's one skinny one there and right there, and this little one right here, that's 10. But they're gonna come back about to where this, probably about where that second green okra plant is right there. So that'll be the first two rows. Because these, you can see this, these are spaced pretty good. They should be a little bit fuller than this, but they look okay, the okra plants. They are about 30 inches apart. Right at 30 inches apart, maybe 36. I'll even actually measure it, so I'll have a measurement. Because what that first burgundy okra is to the second one, this big green, long stem green to the second one, that's about the distance I want them all. Because you, for some reason they're not as full as I thought they would be or could be, should be. So we'll see what happens when I plant next year. But the tomato plants would definitely have to be pulled out more. There's 10 plants there and you see where they're at. The 10th plant should come all the way back to about here. That gives them more space, at least about 12 inches in between. 12 inches more in between. This is, I believe, a pumpkin. It looks like a pumpkin right there. I mean, I don't know if that's watermelon. It might be a watermelon. But I'm thinking it's, see, pumpkin would have more ridges, but see, that feels like it's starting to get ridges in it. So, but right where this is at right here, I don't know now. Get out of the garden there, buddy. Keep it going out there. CJ, get out of the garden. But look how far that one goes. It's from right here. I'm zooming back as far as I can zoom out. It's starting right there. It goes all the way out of the garden over here. See, so this is something that if we have a couple of these on the far side of the garden is what we'll put over here. If this is a squash, I don't know if it's squash. It's pretty bad when we plant so many things and with the tiller not working like it was and not having it for almost a month. All this grass, that's why all the grass out here. These things right here, they will have no idea what they are, but they keep coming back, it seems like, but, you know. Let me just get closer, jeez. This viewfinder really sucks. See how that one's even got flowers, blooms on it? Well, I'm even zooming in on the damn thing. Like that right there, see the flowers on it, it's green. I just watered them and they come back, it seemed like, but look at it now. I watered them yesterday. This one here, don't know. That one there, same thing, it looks like watermelon. The leaves are all, I like that one right there coming over here. That's what I'm saying, I put three of these on the far end over here. I'll let them grow out of the garden. Because see, there's another one right there. That little stem right there makes me think of a pumpkin. But it could be a squash, doubt it, but it could be. So, flowers all over them. This was a bean that was on this. Like I said, this was just, when they overtook with grass, I got upset, and it's my fault I didn't do anything out here with it. But I'm putting different poles out here to get these beans to grow up the pole. Okay, I'll go up a little bit more. I'll wrap this one around a little bit more. Oh, come on, don't do that. I'm gonna hold this for a second. It won't let me wrap. I was trying to wrap that. I wrapped it around three times up this pole, and it just came itself undone again. Jeez. Onions, winter onions in here. Now over here in the far end, see, that's what I say, this is all spread out because of the grass. I should do it in like three sections. The vine's got to be the furthest section out here, but it's got to be completely eradicated of grass. And like I say, until the season is over with, I can't till this up or anything. But see, there's melons in here, two of them at least. I think they're cantaloupe. That one right there, and that one right there. All this grass in here. I reach in by hand and pull the grass out constantly in handfuls and throwing it out here, but you know, to no avail because the stuff just grows right back. So let me get out of this patch without stepping. Oh, here. Here's a squash. It's a squash. Right here. See, it's link. Unless that's a watermelon. I don't, that might be a squash. Wow. Holy cow. I hope, maybe it is. I hope it is squash. Where did I see it? I can't see it down here now. Right there. That looks like squash, maybe. Because of the cylindrical part of it being more elongated. I had two watermelons and two cantaloupe on this little square, and then two watermelons and two little cantaloupe on that little square, but look at how it's all just moving over. Petey, get out of that garden. Get out of there, man. Don't need no dog urine on anything. Okay, so that's the watermelon and cantaloupe, which evidently looks like squash. Like I said, I hope it is squash. Zucchini would be better, but... And then with this bean plant here. See just how this is all discombobulated. It's all mixed up. So look at all these rows. One, two, it was three, four, five, six. There were six rows in here at the beginning. And I made two squares, one there, and one behind that trash can, a little square back there, which, like I said, everything just got out of hand with this grass. You know, it's my fault for letting it get to me like that too, but. And look and see how the tomato plants are all spreading out. And they're right on top of each other, so that's gonna make it hard. I got some red tomatoes in there. If I can zoom in on that. Gosh, I can't see through grassy weeds. I can't see through the viewfinder outside. I think that's them right there. Are those red tomatoes? I can't really see it on the viewfinder. I think it is. So, I got a bunch of red tomatoes out here. And these are cherry tomatoes, 90% of them. This here seems to be my only regular tomato plant. You know, and I'm watering the crap out of it out here. Not crap, but you know, once every other day at the very... Once every 3 days at the very least. I was doing it every day for a while when the heat was real hot, which they recommend. And now it's got, you know, this look. I don't know if it's disease, insects, what? You know, I mean, I'm not a farmer by trade. I've been doing this twice, three times. This is my third time, period. And it's because I've constantly I've moved a little bit too much. Every place I go, I don't have any place to do this. Now I have a place to do this, and we'll hope that things work out for us. I have an interview tomorrow for a warehouse job, which pays okay and would enable us to stay here. And then I can do this garden next year and do a good job. These are all heirloom seeds, every one of them. Nothing is from China Mart. And that's what it's referred to. I will not use the other name because it's from China and it's destroying the nation purposely, not accidentally, purposely. And China Mart is where everybody buys everything. Oh, it's easy just to go to China Mart and get this and get that. Yeah, that's the whole thing. Put everybody else out of business and get people used to it, the convenience. Let's just go there. Yeah. Well, that's part of the reason the economy is as bad as it is, but you really don't understand that yet. Eventually you will. I don't know if I can get those red tomatoes, if I can find them on here. Again, the viewfinder I can't really see in. There they are, I see those. Cherry tomatoes there. And, oh man. There. And there's, let's see, I can count. When I zoom out here, it's easier for me to count from by my naked eye. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Looks like 8 or 9 at least that I can plant. Oh, 9. 10, 11. 10, 11. Of 11, probably 8 of them are almost red. Oh, there's more on the bottom. About 13 or 14 of them. And they're almost all red. There's about 4 that are almost red. So I might go ahead and pick those too, because then they'll just finish off. See, I had to pick this. I hate doing this too. A live plant. But it was hanging off already, and it's still green, so I'm taking that it won't hurt it. This I left before, wasn't sure what it is. Evidently, it is just a weed. I thought maybe that might help detract some of the bugs. And it don't seem like that's doing much work over here. Although the beans right here, this bean plant doesn't have it. Look at it. There's very little. There's a leaf down there that looks like it might need a little help. I can't see right there. Other than that, the rest of it looks fairly healthy. It's 2 or 3 small insect pieces. Bomb. Where they chew. Out, Peter! Pepper plants. I got a couple peppers on that big pepper plant over there. Go over by the house where I've got 9 pepper plants, I think. Like I said, I'm going to end up doing this on paper because, you know, it's on video. It's easier to see it on paper for me to put it into my mind. I have to see it firsthand, and I have to record it helps, and then I want to put it on paper so I can have a mapped out plan. Okay. One of the little bell peppers fell off yesterday. I took it out. There's a bigger one right here. See if I can get, I want to touch it now. Right there. And you got some flowers on it. Blooms where more will possibly come out. And my hand was getting caught in my ring, so I have to keep taking it off. I can't really see them in this one here or that one. No blooms or no peppers. The first two, the third one's got that bell pepper. It's got 1, 2 blooms on it. This one has a couple small blooms, it looks like, right there. No peppers on it. This one here's got a bloom right here. This one, I think that pepper fell off of yesterday too. Probably from bumping it, I didn't realize I did, or the dogs might have went across it and bumped it. A couple of blooms on there, habaneros. Got one here, one down here. Oh, 3 of them, 3 habanero peppers. Those are real hot peppers, that would be good to have. So I'm gonna try putting those peppers in the garden next year also. They say full sun, and like I said, we have full sun. I'd say about 90% of the time, and this is in sun. You know, which when it's hot, though, it kind of like seems like it'll burn it up or dry it out. Hello.